A comprehensive strategy for Giga Bay was recently unveiled, not at Starbase but in Florida, indicating SpaceX's bold aspirations for a global aerospace hub. It is likely that related initiatives will emerge in the near future. In recent developments, NASA's controversial DEIA system, which has sparked much debate in recent years, is set to expire under a new administration. Meanwhile, Hubble has made another interesting discovery, further fueling the curiosity. Let's dive deeper into today's episode of NR Studio. Since late last year, Giga Bay has emerged as a focal point of interest, captivating many space enthusiasts. Initially teased in November 2024, the project garnered significant attention following SpaceX's hiring announcement, which alluded to this groundbreaking new initiative. At the time, a large number of individuals, including myself, were convinced that Giga Bay would be realized at Starbase. Furthermore, it solidified its status as SpaceX's primary production hub. However, the latest update has caught us all by surprise. On January 22, 2025, SpaceX revealed that Giga Bay would indeed be realized. However, it would not be located at Starbase. Instead, the ambitious venture is set to take shape in Cape Canaveral, Florida. The designated site, as detailed in a recent FAA update, places Giga Bay adjacent to SpaceX's current Robert Road Starship facility. The structure will strategically position itself on the northeast corner of the facility, significantly increasing SpaceX's footprint in this important aerospace region. Construction is anticipated to begin on April 1, 2025, with an expected completion date of August 2, 2026. That timeline, which extends a little over a year and 4 months, is in keeping with SpaceX's history of rapid construction. To put that into context, construction of Megabay 2, Starbase's current assembly facility, took about 7 months. Nevertheless, Giga Bay is anticipated to surpass in size and sophistication, thereby accounting for the prolonged timeline. Moreover, SpaceX will require additional time for site preparation prior to the commencement of construction activities. All operations are progressing seamlessly. Giga Bay may become functional by the conclusion of 2026, precisely aligning with SpaceX's ambitious initiatives for Starship production and launch activities in Florida. The ramifications of this endeavor are considerable. The completion of Giga Bay will furnish SpaceX with a state-of-the-art vertical assembly facility, crucial for enhancing Starship production capacity. This holds significant importance, considering SpaceX's objective to conduct as many as Starship missions each year from Florida. Moreover, the facility is expected to concentrate significantly on the fabrication of Starship HLS prototypes for NASA's Artemis lunar endeavors. In conjunction with the continual enhancements to launch Complex 39A, the establishment of Giga Bay fortifies Cape Canaveral's position as a pivotal center for SpaceX aspirations in lunar and deep space exploration. Let us now delve deeper into the particulars of Giga Bay's dimensions and architectural design. Per FAA documentation, the edifice will reach an impressive height of 388.2 feet, approximately 118.2 meters, which encompasses an elevation of 8 feet, 2 meters for the site, and the principal structure measuring 380 feet, 115.8 meters. This exceeds the projected height of 100 meters for Giga Bay and Giga Bay 2, thereby offering sufficient vertical clearance to house the complete Starship assembly, even as the vehicle progresses into its V3 version. In terms of width, Giga Bay is anticipated to exceed its predecessor substantially, potentially reaching dimensions 1.5 to 2 times greater than those of prior Giga Bay structures. Giga Bay and Giga Bay 2 are projected to have widths ranging from 35 to 50 meters, while Giga Bay itself may attain widths of up to 100 to 118 meters. These dimensions would yield a cube-like configuration, incorporating a minimum of 2 expansive doors, thereby facilitating the concurrent processing of multiple Starship and Super Heavy prototypes. It is reasonable to anticipate that Giga Bay has the capacity to accommodate between 10 to 15 prototypes simultaneously, thereby enabling a degree of production efficiency unprecedented in SpaceX's history. This augmented capacity would enable Giga Bay to concurrently facilitate the stacking, refurbishment, and outfitting of multiple prototypes, significantly surpassing the existing capabilities of the High Bay and Mega Bay facilities at Starbase. With Giga Bay now fully operational, SpaceX is poised to significantly expedite its Starship production rate, paving the way for an unparalleled launch frequency. Envision a continuous procession of starships navigating in and out of Giga Bay, perpetually shifting between the facility and the launch pad. This tableau exemplifies SpaceX's dedication to rendering starship flights an everyday occurrence. Beyond Giga Bay, this initiative could facilitate further enhancements to the existing infrastructure. For instance, a novel star factory may be established in Florida to accommodate the augmented demands resulting from Giga Bay. This would signify SpaceX's inaugural significant advancement in replicating its automated rocket production model beyond Starbase, augmenting its capacity to fulfill the surging demand for Starship missions. However, the thrill does not conclude at that point. Reports indicate that a comparable Giga Bay structure is anticipated to be constructed at Starbase to supplant the aging High Bay. The anticipated second Giga Bay is projected to replicate the dimensions and functionalities of its Florida equivalent, thereby solidifying Starbase's status as a crucial nexus for SpaceX's operations. Collectively, these facilities will enable SpaceX to achieve its audacious objective of executing as many as 00 Starship flights within the forthcoming 4 years, a milestone that has the potential to transform its accessibility to space. These advancements signify a significant progression for SpaceX and the Starship initiative. As the enterprise advances its expansion efforts, the prospective utilizations for Starship, spanning from lunar expeditions to interplanetary voyages, become progressively concrete. The development of Giga Bay in Florida transcends mere logistical enhancement. It constitutes a daring declaration regarding SpaceX's aspirations for the future. If you share my enthusiasm for SpaceX's recent strategies regarding Giga Bay, please indicate so by commenting Giga. Moreover, kindly remember to like the video and subscribe to our channel to ensure you remain informed about the remarkable journey of SpaceX. Collectively, let us embark on each phase of this transformative journey as humankind advances towards its next monumental stride into the cosmos. Having discussed the recent developments at SpaceX, let us now turn our attention to NASA, which has made substantial advancements in the evolution of its policies. In the course of this transition, executive orders have been enacted to shut down offices and discontinue programs linked to DEIA initiatives. This significant development was officially communicated through a memorandum issued by interim NASA Administrator Janet Petro on January 22nd, representing a crucial juncture in the trajectory of the HSC. The White House articulated these proposals within the framework of comprehensive initiatives designed to terminate radical and inefficient government DEI programs, prioritize necessary adjustments, and initially rescind detrimental executive orders and actions. These initiatives aim to mitigate what the administration characterizes as substantial public waste and egregious discrimination. The memorandum additionally recognizes the potential for a series of actions aimed at evading these alterations, urging employees to report any such occurrences within a 10-day amnesty window. The caution articulated is unequivocal. Neglecting to disclose pertinent information during this grace period may lead to unfavorable repercussions for those who fail to adhere to compliance. The memorandum endorsed by Janet Petro delineated that all mentions of DEIA must be expunged from NASA's communications and publicly accessible materials by 5 p.m. Eastern on January 22nd. Furthermore, agencies have been instructed to record any reductions in the DEIA workforce by January 31st and to provide lists of contracts or position descriptions altered post-November 5, 202, in order to obscure ties to DEIA initiatives. In her statement regarding this transition, Janet Petro underscored the significance of cultivating an inclusive workplace. A significant aspect of this initiative is fostering an environment in which all individuals feel included, empowered to articulate their viewpoints, and assured of their safety in doing so, she articulated. Petro emphasized her long-standing mentorship of minority individuals throughout her career and reaffirmed her dedication to steering the Kennedy Space Center with an emphasis on diversity and inclusion. Nevertheless, the resolution to terminate the DEIA program has provoked substantial responses from NASA personnel and prospective job candidates, inciting a vigorous discourse regarding the advantages and disadvantages of the initiative. The DEIA initiative has generated considerable debate and division over the years. Although certain individuals assert that it has fostered equity and inclusivity, others argue that it has resulted in inefficiencies and superfluous expenditures. As NASA shifts its focus away from DEIA initiatives, there is widespread expectation of a comprehensive organizational restructuring to better align with the priorities of the new administration. With Jared Isaacman at the helm, poised to steer NASA into a transformative epoch, the agency appears to be refocusing on its foundational mission of innovation and exploration. This decision prompts a multitude of inquiries, particularly regarding how NASA will adeptly manage these transitions while upholding its dedication to fostering an inclusive work environment. What is your perspective regarding the conclusion of DEIA? We invite you to express your views in the comments below as we explore this subject further. In the concluding segment of today's episode, we are thrilled to present some captivating developments from the realm of astronomy. The Hubble Space Telescope has once again showcased its exceptional prowess by delivering the most intricate image to date of the Andromeda Galaxy, our nearest galactic companion. This accomplishment represents the pinnacle of a 10-year endeavor aimed at constructing an extensive depiction of Andromeda, uncovering novel insights into the architecture and evolution of spiral galaxies. The pursuit of this revelation commenced in 2015, when astronomers initially compiled images of the northern hemisphere of Andromeda, utilizing the high-resolution observations provided by the Hubble Space Telescope. The preliminary endeavor resulted in a stunning mosaic, encapsulating 100 million stars and approximately 1.5 billion pixels. Nonetheless, the southern hemisphere of the galaxy remained an unexplored frontier, up to the present moment. During the 25th American Astronomical Society, AAS press conference held in Maryland, Joachim from the University of Washington revealed the successful culmination of this significant project. By combining images of Andromeda's southern hemisphere, astronomers have effectively expanded the mosaic scope, which now includes the glow of nearly 200 million stars. This sweeping view is the most expansive portrait of the galaxy ever assembled from Hubble observations, revealing an extraordinary level of detail, akin to capturing a picture of a beach where grains of sand can be seen, Chen said. This is the first time we have witnessed such detailed external galactic structure. The Andromeda Galaxy, located about 2.5 million light years from Earth, appears in the night sky with a diameter 6 times that of the full moon, making it a formidable subject for Hubble's precise imaging capabilities. Assembling the mosaic required the careful stitching together of many individual portraits obtained over the course of the telescope's 1,000 orbits. The result is a stunning visual creation that not only highlights the galaxy's splendor, but also serves as a vital instrument for scientific inquiry. The detailed depiction of Andromeda will empower astronomers to explore its dynamic past, with a particular focus on its interactions with smaller satellite galaxies. By carefully examining the distribution, age, and elemental composition of stars, researchers can evaluate and compare different models of galaxy formation and evolution. These findings have the potential to shed light on the mechanisms that influence the formation of spiral galaxies throughout the cosmos. Ben Williams of the University of Washington emphasized the importance of this milestone, noting that with Hubble, we can achieve an unprecedented level of detail about the full range of phenomena occurring across the disk of galaxies. Such a feat is not possible with other expansive galaxies. Despite its age, the Hubble Space Telescope perpetuates its legacy of groundbreaking discoveries that have advanced our understanding of the universe. While contemporary telescopes such as the James Webb provide additional functions, Hubble continues to be a vital instrument for unraveling the mysteries of our universe. Andromeda Mosaic is a remarkable testament to Hubble's lasting legacy and its important contributions to the advancement of astronomical research. Amid the challenges and uncertainty surrounding its long-term viability, the telescope's recent accomplishments are a powerful testament to its significant contributions to science and humanity. From NASA's groundbreaking policy reforms to the Hubble Space Telescope's stunning revelations, the odyssey of space exploration is a testament to the harmonious interplay of human creativity and determination. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.